In this video tutorial, I want to share with you how to use WeTransfer to transfer files from yourself to your students, from your computer to your colleague's computer, or from your computer to your students or your fellow professionals' computer. And it's very easy to share and download. They can download very easily online and they can use it at their own end of the computer. So I know most of you might think that if you are sharing on WeTransfer, I think it's kind of a small website or small platform where you can share documents. Why not use Google Drive? Why not use OneDrive? Why not use Dropbox for all that feature? But I think in some cases, the students may not have access to OneDrive or Dropbox, or in some cases, Google Drive. WeTransfer, I think, is kind of light and very simple to use. You don't even need to sign in. You don't need to sign up for anything. No need for you to use any password. You can easily just quickly share files within yourselves. Okay, so to start with, all you need to do is to come to WeTransfer.com over here, and then you can come over here and agree to the terms and conditions, and you can easily select files from here, or you can select a particular folder containing files, and then you can bring in over here. So let's say we want to send in a file, for example. So let's click on upload a file, and you can see you can come all the way to select a given file. For example, we come to videos over here, and we can select any file. Let's say I'm sending this PPT, and then we can select to open, and you can see it is just 85 megabyte. Usually for the free version, you have up to 2 gigabyte of data to send per sending of a message. You can send up to 2 gigabyte. So right now it has taken 85 megabyte, and it's, I have up to 1.9 gigabyte left. Okay, so you can keep adding documents. You can add more if you want, for example, files or folder anywhere. You can select within your document, and you can just easily pick anything. For example, I pick this one, and maybe I pick these two, and I can select the two of them, and I can see, you can see it has just been uploaded. Okay, so the next thing you need to do is to just type in the email address you are sending it. Okay, so you can type your own email address so that the person can actually know who is sending the message, and then you can put in your the title of the message. And we can say something like, all right, down here you can put in any message, so you can just type in. So once you click on transfer, it's going to start, but then you have these three dots. You can check them to see. You have two ways to send this message. You can send via email transfer, and you can get a transferable link to just send it to just share with your students or your colleagues. So for example, let's say with the email transfer, you just click on transfer, verify your email. It has given a code to this email, so you just get the code and just put it. Okay, so in my own case, it's 109040. Can just click to verify this, and it is now transferring the file. You can see the progress from here, and once it is done, it's going to show to you that it has transferred. Okay, so this is going to take some time, so let me just give you some time for it to transfer. And what actually it's doing is it is copying the files from your computer and it's dumping it or sending it to the other person's computer. All right, so I think it has finished the transfer, and you can see it, you are done. The transfer email has been sent. Your transfer is available for 7 days. So the person receiving this message has 7 days to download this file from this computer, from this link. And you can create, send another one if you want. So let's see from the other end of the receiver what he receives. WeTransfer, you see it over here, you just received, and you can just click and you can see the message. Okay, so it's sent you PPT for thumbnails is it the title we sent, if you remember. So you just click on this, and it has a download link also at the bottom. So you click to get your files, and once you click, it's going to pop up that you should download the file from here. And once you download, you can view it and you can do all sort of things with it. So this is what he sees from his own end. So alternatively, if you want to do the same thing, you can send another one. So you can maybe add the same files, but this time around, you are going to take a link to it. You are going to take it a link. So for example, we are sending it to the same person. It's me who is sending, and we put the title and we put the message, whatever, and then we can come to the three dots over here. But this time around, we get transfer link, and we can say get link, and it's going to process and give us the link. Right now it's 100% and we can just copy this link. See, the link has just been copied by just me clicking on it. So what the other end is going to do is, as soon as he gets the link, you can use it to send to their email address, or you can paste it in your WhatsApp group or anywhere. Once he gets the link, you paste the link on the browser, it's going to have it open and easily he can download the same way. Okay, ready when you are. Transfer within 7 days. So you can see, you can just easily click to download. You have even the warning that you have 7 days to download this document. So once you click, you can download it very easily. Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit on how to use WeTransfer. Very easy to use software to transfer document from one computer to another. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to always hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.